In this video, we're going to go through how to draw polymers made through addition polymerization. Just a quick intro to addition polymerization. Polymer is like a beads necklace. It's made out of lots of beads linked together like this. Those beads are called monomer. And the process of making this necklace is called addition polymerization. This type of polymerization uses up all the atoms in the monomers. That means there's no small molecules like water removed when linking them up together. We will draw polymers from different types of monomers in this video. The first one we'll start with is the simplest one, consisting of alkene with one C-C double bond. Then we'll advance to monomer with two C-C double bond. And lastly, we'll look at copolymer, which is made from two or more monomers. Let's get started. Notice how I draw the skeletal structure of the monomer. It'll be good to keep this in mind. It will save you from making future mistakes. For monomer with one C-C double bond, draw the two carbons connected with double bonds like this, and then draw out the two remaining bonds on each carbon sticking up and down like this. This is very important. Don't place any of the bonds on the right and the left hand side of the carbon. It might confuse you when trying to form the polymer later. Here are some examples of monomers with one C-C double bond. Notice how they are not drawn according to our preferred way. Well, let's convert them. I color-coded the groups attached to carbon to make it easier to see. Notice how the groups are placed on the bonds up and down the carbon. Let's start making our first polymer. What we'll need to do is place several monomers next to each other. Remember the beads necklace? We link the beads together using strings. Well, in reality, the monomers will go through radical reactions to form the polymers. But I'm going to show you a simplified way of thinking to make life easy. Here we go. Imagine we have a double bond from one monomer to make a bond with the monomer next to it. So we move the double bond. This process will keep going and it usually involves tens of thousands of monomers, but I'm sure you get the picture with just these five monomers here. Once we link them up, we have the structure of the polymer showing repeating units. Important point to note, when drawing polymer, make sure that both ends of the structure have open-ended bonds like this. This is to note that there are lots of monomers linked up, it's just that we didn't draw them out. Sometimes, we just don't want to draw the same thing over and over, and in that case, we can present the structure of polymer in a shorthand form. Just draw out the repeating unit with the open-ended bonds, place a bracket over it, and end at the bottom right. That end is to indicate that we have lots of these linked up together, and in this case has value of tens of thousands. We just drew the structure of polymer made from monomer with one C-C double bond. Now let's move on to working with monomer with two C-C double bond. Notice how it's a little bit different? We now have an alkene with four carbons instead of two. And we have alternating double, single, and double bond. We know carbon can make four bonds. So after drawing out the double, single, double bonds, you can fill out the remaining bonds by placing it pointing up and down. Remember to keep the bonds pointing up and down and out of the way. No bonds on the right and the left. Here's our monomer with two double bonds. In principle, it works the same as monomer with one double bond. It's a radical reaction. But again, we'll simplify our thinking and we just move the double bonds. The difference with the previous monomer is we'll need to make two moves to link the monomers. Watch. Once we have the monomers linked up, we now have the structure of a polymer showing three repeating units. Do you notice the double bond in every repeating unit? That's present because we use the monomer with two double bonds. For the shorthand structure, all we have to do is draw out the repeating unit with open-ended bonds, place the bracket over it and end at the bottom right, and we're done. Now that we know how to draw polymer from the two types of monomer, we can essentially mix and match them up. That will give us copolymers. Polymer that are made out of the same monomer is like this beads necklace made out of the same blue color beads. When you mix the beads up, you get a multicolor necklace like this. And that's exactly what copolymer is. It's made from two or more monomers. Let's say we have two monomers. We'll call the first one monomer A and the second one monomer B. Assuming the pattern is going to be a 1-to-1 ratio, that means our polymer is going to have AB, AB, AB pattern. So we'll place the two monomers like this, AB, AB. I don't have space for more, so I'll just place four. To form the polymer, we just need to do what we've been doing all this while, which is move the double bonds to link them up. Here's our copolymer showing repeating units. And the shorthand version includes the repeating unit of A and B inside the bracket. To recap, we drew polymers from three types of monomers. One with CC double bond, another one with two CC double bond. Don't forget to place the bonds on top and bottom of the carbons out of the way. Lastly, we drew a copolymer where we have two monomers alternating with each other. We can present the structure in two ways, showing repeating units or shorthand form. Don't forget the open-ended bonds in both forms. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.